Welcome to the broadcast. I'm David Feldman. On today's program, the incredible Andrea Martin, along with Paul Dooley and Janie Haddad Tompkins. Stay with us.
Are you a woman? Are you tired of having control over your own body? Is a painful, invasive procedure by total strangers in a cold, impersonal setting exactly what you've been looking for? Well, now, participating Walgreens drugstores in association with the Republican National Committee announced the grand opening of our new ultrasound-on-the-go clinic, Jiffy Badge. If you are a career gal who has committed unholy acts that are an affront to God, but don't want your state-mandated ultrasound to be an affront to your pocketbook, Jiffy Badge is the answer to your prayers if a promiscuous tramp like you ever bothered to pray. It's only a matter of time before all states require women seeking abortions to get an ultrasound. So why not do it at your neighborhood strip mall, where you can get all your shopping done and still have time to view a sonogram of the fetus you're planning to murder. But don't take our word for it.
The violation in my uterus was so quick and easy, and I never thought I could become so permanently traumatized at so low a price.
Whether you prefer the liquid gel method or the more rapey metallic insertion option, Jiffy Vag clinics are there to service all the women's reproductive decisions that you, as a woman, don't deserve to have a say in.
I was shamed and psychically scarred for life in a convenient location right next to Applebee's.
Jiffy Vag.
I haven't stopped sobbing since the procedure, but the parking was free with validation.
So be sure to visit your neighborhood Jiffy Vag clinic, where great savings begin at conception.
After 56 sponsors dropped Rush Limbaugh this week, most of the commercials on Limbaugh's radio show today were public service announcements. He's just giving it away. Who's the slut now, Rush? Some stations have already dropped Rush Limbaugh, realizing they can attract the same exact audience by simply playing the sound of a warthog caught in a bear trap. If you remember, Rush Limbaugh got into trouble last week when he became confused and called a woman a prostitute instead of calling a prostitute. Reverend Pat Robertson says marijuana should be legalized and then announced the 700 Club will be marked down to 420. Robertson says he himself never smokes marijuana because he's addicted to a much stronger opiate, organized religion. According to a new study, 90% of all voters in this year's Republican primaries were white. The other 10% were really white. Meanwhile, Washington Republicans are starting to gear up for all-out war with Iran by making sure their draft-age children are eligible for college deferments.
Welcome back to the Vatican Radio Network. I'm Father Aloysius Dooley. A lot of you Catholics out there aren't paying any attention to me when I talk about women's issues, especially the women. So I thought maybe you'd listen to my next guest, who happens to be a woman. But unlike many of you, she is a nun, so she knows what she's talking about, especially when it comes to sex. She's Mother Magda from the Celibacy Project. Welcome to the show, Mother.
Nice to be on show, Father Dooley.
It's good to have you here, Mother Magda. Where is your church located?
My church located Eastern Europe.
Could you be more specific?
Maple Street, near the subway.
Now, much like myself, you are your church's resident expert on all matters pertaining to sexual behavior. Does that include deviant behavior?
Depends on you buy me dinner.
Okay, the lines are open, folks. You can ask Mother Magda anything as long as you're Catholic and you're trying to remain celibate. Hello, Beth from Virginia Beach. You're on the air.
Hello, Father.
Yes, do you have a question for Mother Magda?
Yes, I do. Mother Magda.
Yes, dear, what is question?
Well, I'm 21 years old, and I've been dating the same man for the last 3 years. But lately, we seem to be having a problem.
Boyfriend looks at porn, yes?
No, he doesn't.
Right. Of course he doesn't.
Beth, are you having physical relations with this man?
No, Father. That's the problem. We're not having sex because we're not married.
Sounds like things are going just fine, Beth. Please don't call the show again unless you need me to tell you not to have sex.
Hey, Dooley, back off.
It's my show, and it's Father, Mother.
Father, Mother, please don't fight.
Talk to me, Beth. You're still there.
Yes, Mother Magda. My boyfriend has these urges, but we can't get married. We're still in college, and I'm a virgin. What should I do?
Beth, if you want to keep boyfriend, have to find ways to please him, and still you are pure.
How do I do that, Mother?
You need to play with his, how can I put this, with his schmeckenwoken.
You got that, Beth?
His what?
His schmeckenwoken.
Thanks for calling, Beth. I hope we've been of some help to you.
I don't understand. I had to play with his what?
His schmeckenwoken. Are you deaf?
I'm sorry. I am so naive about these things. That's why I need your help.
Okay, Beth, listening to me. When you with boyfriend, you take his schmeckenwoken and you put it in your gorkenmuffin.
My gorkenmuffin?
Do you want to keeping your man or not keeping him?
I want to keeping him, I do.
Listen to myself saying you doing this with his schmeckenwoken in your gorkenmuffin. Try it one time.
Would you mind explaining?
Jesus Christ.
She's a kid. She don't know nothing.
Excuse me, but I'm not as clear on this as I'd like to be.
Beth, ugh, have you never had your boyfriend's broomshickles on top of your maxabas?
I don't think so.
Not even once?
No.
After the prom?
No, I haven't.
Boy.
Beth, I think you're lying.
I'm Catholic, Father. I don't lie.
But where have you been? Under a rock?
I just don't want to get pregnant.
You silly goose. You can't get pregnant through your gorkenmuffin.
He's right. It's impossible. It could never happen.
And I'll still be a virgin?
Of course, damn it.
Well, I enjoy it too.
Yes, and it's good for your complexion.
Is that true, Mother Magda?
I don't know about that, Beth. It's a mystery. Like everything in the Catholic Church.
Well, thank you, Mother Magda. I can hardly wait to do that thing you said.
I'll bet you can't.
Good luck, Beth. But remember one thing.
Yes, Mother?
Whatever you do, don't let him near your vagina.
There's a great debate that's raging all across this mighty land. A battle over birth control that's getting out of hand. So I have some examples that will help you understand that parenthood should absolutely not be planned. Just suppose that Einstein's father used a condom, tell you what. It could have been a big door to the future slamming shut. 'Cause that sperm named Albert Einstein might not have made the cut. And that's why I oppose Planned Parenthood. Now think of the Wright brothers of aviation fame. Imagine that their parents played the contraception game. We'd still be taking boats to Europe, and they would be to blame. And that's why I oppose Planned Parenthood. Oh, please don't think that I'm intolerant. I genuinely love my neighbor. But I love my neighbor even more when my neighbor is in labor. Oh, the Catholics have strong beliefs. They simply can't ignore them. You mention contraceptives and they tell you they abhor them. And if not for this rigid rule, there might be no Santorum. And that's just a moment, friends. I find that I've somehow changed my mind. Now I support Planned Parenthood.
And now, as part of its ongoing commitment to humorless programming, National Public Radio presents That's Not Funny with your host, Skylar Umbridge.
Hello, I'm Skylar Umbridge. Welcome to That's Not Funny. My first guest is Melissa Jordan, the author of a new book, How Feminism Lost Its Way. Welcome, Ms. Jordan.
That's Mrs. Jordan. When I got married, I took my husband's name, as I believe all true feminists should.
Really?
Yes. The whole idea of equal pay, equal opportunity, and having control over one's own body is antithetical to what I believe to be true feminism.
Well, to my mind, the points you are making are in fact the exact opposite of true feminism.
Okay, admittedly, the entire premise of my book is wrong. But why would you even expect me to write a good book? I am a woman, after all.
What?
There's a whole chapter in my book about how women are too stupid to write books. I'd encourage you to read it, but I don't think women have any business reading. That's a man's job.
I can only guess by your logic that you vote Republican.
Vote? You think women should have the right to vote? And you call yourself a feminist? I guess you're one of those crazy modern newfangled lipstick lesbian feminists.
That's not funny.
Of course it's not funny. Women aren't funny. Don't you know that?
Get out of here. Get out!
Excuse me, dear. Can I say one more thing?
What?
Santorum 2012!
Get out!
Woo! Woo!
My next guest on That's Not Funny is Professor Darlene Markham, who is here to tell us about her new scholarly study.
Thank you. My new book is called A Lighter Side of Suicide, and it's a whimsical look at some of the hilarious things famous authors have said when they're about to kill themselves.
I have to admit, I didn't really know there was a lighter side to suicide.
Oh, but there is. For instance, right before Ernest Hemingway placed a rifle in his mouth and pulled the trigger, he said, "This bullet will be the first non-fattening thing I've eaten all day." Isn't that adorable?
I'm not so sure.
But wait. Wait till you get a load of this. Do you know what Anne Sexton, the poet, said right before she took her own life?
What?
She said, "Oh, my God, I'm so depressed. I just want to die." What a stitch.
I'm sorry, but I really don't see what's so witty about what she said.
It's the way she said it. The thing is, in order to appreciate the humor in most suicides, you really had to be there.
I think I kind of disagree with the premise of your book. I don't believe that people committing suicide are necessarily interested in turning the most anguished moment of their lives into an amusing anecdote.
Well, sometimes it's the folks around the suicidal person who come up with a zinger. For instance, as you probably know, Sylvia Plath killed herself by sticking her head in the oven. When her husband Ted found her without missing a beat, he said, "Well, I guess tonight it's not going to be stovetop stuffing or potatoes."
I simply do not believe that Ted Hughes said that.
Ted Hughes? Who's that?
Ted Hughes, Sylvia Plath's husband.
What are you talking about? Sylvia Plath's husband was Ted Key, the cartoonist who created the Hazel comic strip?
No. Sylvia Plath's husband was Ted Hughes, the famous British poet. This is common knowledge. Everybody knows it.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, my God. My book has already gone to press, and I've made a gigantic error in scholarship. This is going to destroy my career. No tenure, no grants, no fellowships. I'm ruined. I'm going to kill myself.
Well, that should help sales of your book. Hey, you're right. It is easy to come up with a quip under these circumstances.
That's not funny!
Yes, it is. It's the only funny thing I've ever said. Your moment of suicidal despair has provided me with the first lighthearted moment of my life, and how dare you try to diminish that? And I'm the one who says that's not funny around here. Now get out! Get out! Get out! My next guest on That's Not Funny is Florence Phillips, who during our last pledge drive made a generous donation to NPR and thus won the Be a Guest on That's Not Funny gift. Florence, thank you so much for your support.
My pleasure. That's Not Funny is my favorite program. And you, Skylar Umbridge, are the light of my life. I am your biggest fan.
Thank you so much. So tell us, Florence, what do you do for a living?
I live off a trust fund. I don't have to work, so I'm able to focus on what I'm passionate about, which is you, Skylar. I know everything about you.
Well, I'm very grateful that you're such a fan, but outside of the show, I do try to maintain a very private life.
I know. That's what you said in your email to your father last week.
What? Did you hack into my email?
No, I could never do that, so I hired a computer hacker to do it for me. But don't worry, I would never share your information with others. I can't speak for him, though.
Oh, my God. I feel so violated.
But you would love to be violated by that barista at Starbucks you have a crush on, but have never worked up the courage to talk to.
How do you know about that? Did you read my diary?
I would never do that. I read it in the dream journal that you keep next to your bed.
You broke into my apartment when I wasn't there?
Well, oftentimes I break in when you are there and I hide under your bed. I find the sound of your vibrator very soothing.
That's not funny! Get out of here!
You said that's not funny to me. I am so honored.
Get out! Get out! Get out!
This is the greatest moment of my life.
That's it for this week's edition of That's Not Funny. Join me next week. Actually, I'm not sure I want you to join me next week.
You don't have a choice, Skylar. I've already picked out my outfit.
I am so creeped out. Good night.
That's Not Funny is made possible by listeners like you. Crazy, unstable, sociopathic listeners like you.
I'm Meredith Vieira, and today I'm here outside Mitt Romney's estate, about to enter the grounds to interview. Here he is now. It's Mitt Romney's dog. Good boy. Who's a good boy? Who's an ook and wookum?
Well, I guess I am. I'm pleased to meet you, Meredith. Please, call me Mutt.
Mutt Romney.
Correct. So when do I get my chance to win $1 million? Come on, ask me a question.
No, that's my other gig. Hosting Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. This is my journalist stick.
You brought a stick?
I'm so sorry.
Just as well. You know what my master Mitt calls millionaires?
Poor folk.
Zingo. Have I told you that one before?
Lucky guess. This estate is beautiful.
Thank you. I didn't design it, though the ripped-up patches of grass and the urine stains on the fence posts are all mine.
Very tasteful. Wow, look at all those Cadillacs. There must be dozens.
My master Mitt bought them for me to chase. He knows that I don't chase foreign imports.
On that subject, I've been meaning to ask you about the famous incident where your master, I mean Mitt, put you in a crate on top of the car during a family trip to Canada.
You've been reading too much Gail Collins. In this house, she's for paper training, not reading. First of all, I like riding in a crate on the roof. I'm a risk taker, an extreme animal. An alpha dog. I parasail, I cliff dive. I tell 12-year-old girls that Justin Bieber can't sing.
If you're such a fearless creature, what about the story that you soiled the crate and that your watery stool dripped down the back windshield of Romney's station wagon?
I'm also a competitive eater, too. I just won a fried clam eating contest at the Westminster Kennel Club show.
I didn't know the Westminster... Oh, my goodness. Is this Mr. Romney's mansion?
Oh, this little shack? Don't be silly. It's my doghouse.
A doghouse? It's at least 5 stories high. And there's a wave pool, and is that a cabana out back?
Please don't attack my success. It shows that you're anti-capitalism. Come on, mind your step.
Is it steep?
No, it's where I poop.
Oops, I'll just follow you. My, this room is gorgeous. Is it the living room?
No, it's the elevator.
The walls feel so soft and fuzzy. Ooh, what's that?
Cat fur.
Oh!
We're in the basement.
This is very exotic. I love the art installation on the wall.
It's my collection of dog leashes.
You have hundreds of them, and I love this collection of porcelain pieces.
Those are toilet bowls.
Do you use them to go to the bathroom?
Of course not. Care for a sip? They're stocked with Evian.
Not feeling thirsty.
So, Meredith, would you put a leash on me? The leather one?
Why? Do you want to go for a walk?
No, but come on. Put a leash on me.
Look, I don't really see the point.
Tell me to sit.
No, I don't want to.
Tell me to sit.
Sit.
Say it like you mean it.
Sit, boy, down.
Yes. Now, tell me to roll over.
Roll over. Now shake.
Yes, that's it. Now, beat me on the nose with a rolled-up newspaper.
What is wrong with you?
I'm a bad dog. Call me a bad dog.
No, seriously, what is wrong with you?
I'm a dog. We all want to be treated like this. Why do you think humans keep us around?
Protection, companionship.
Wrong. You humans keep dogs around because you need someone to dominate. Someone who puts up with your crap just to get fed.
It's been great meeting you.
Please, fake throw the tennis ball. I love when you torture me that way.
This has been Meredith Vieira with Mitt Romney's dog. Next week, I'll interview the poodle that lives on top of Newt Gingrich's head. Now get off my leg. Down, boy, down. Hey. Oh, my. That's starting to feel kind of good.
Come on, baby. Pull my choke collar.
Well,
I'm a dog, so I like it rough. Now you want to do it human style?
Welcome to Frank Conniff's America. My guest today, coming to us directly from the lower bowels of hell, is Andrew Breitbart.
Stop raping people! Stop raping people! Stop raping people!
Andrew, why are you saying that to me?
I'm not saying it to you. I'm saying it to John Wayne Gacy. I can see him through the billowing flames just a few feet from me. And he won't stop raping people. I mean, before my orientation was finished, he raped me 3 times.
Yikes.
Wait, Jeffrey Dahmer just walked past. Jeffrey, stop eating people. Stop eating people. Stop eating people. Man, it is awful down here.
Because you're surrounded by unadulterated evil?
No, I'm used to that. I've been to Ann Coulter's house. What's awful is that nobody pays attention to me down here. That's what makes it hell for me.
You're not the media star you were on Earth?
No. There aren't any lazy broadcasters down here who show my doctored videos and treat me as if I were a legitimate journalist. It sucks.
Are you trying to make a splash down there?
Of course. On my new website, bigafterlife.com, I posted a twit pic of Hitler's penis, proving once and for all that he only has one testicle. Adolf just took a crap on my face and laughed it off. It was no big deal to him.
Wow, getting defecated on by Hitler must be pretty degrading.
I didn't really notice it because I was being sodomized by Roy Cohen at the time.
Oh.
Then I posted a doctored video of Satan saying, "I love Jesus." But I edited it, so you didn't hear the complete clip where he said, "I love Jesus when he has hemorrhoids because I like to see him suffer."
Did that bring you the attention you crave so much?
Not at all. When I pulled dishonest stuff like that on Earth, I was put on TV, the media fawned over me, and my website got millions of hits, and I made tons of money. Down here, Satan just shrugged, told me as punishment, I have to dry hump Phyllis Schlafly for 1,000 years when she gets here.
That sounds harsh.
In this place, it's a slap on the wrist. Right now, Lee Atwater is in the midst of a 10,000-year golden shower from Claire Booth Luce. So I got off easy.
Well, Andrew, good luck with your eternity in hell. You are missed up here.
Am I?
No, not really.
But doesn't everybody miss my hateful hijinks?
Well, they did for about a minute or two, but then Rush Limbaugh picked up the hateful conservative slack in a big way.
Really? Say, could you give Rush a message for me?
Sure.
Actually, I'm sure I'll eventually get to tell him in person. Never mind.
Well, thank you, Andrew Breitbart, for joining us from the lower bowels of hell. This is Frank Conniff, and this has been Frank Conniff's America. Good night.
Stop raping people! Stop raping people!
Today's show is written by Steve Rosenfield, Frank Conniff, and Guy Nicolucci. It features Andrea Martin, Paul Dooley, Janie, Haddad Tompkins, Jeremy S. Kramer, and Frank Conniff. Special material by Alan Chapman. We are mixed and engineered by Alex Steen, edited by Darren Ayers, and our executive producer is Troy Conrad.
two-gun Andy from Diablo. Sure can twirl a gun and shoot it too with an aim that's true. I'm better than anyone. And if you find yourself in danger, wondering what to do, I bet that two-gun Andy from Diablo will save the day for you. Now there's a sweet little pigtail filly you have got to meet. All the cowpokes round these parts agree she can't be beat. Now she can handle a pair of 45s like no one's ever done. Then sang a song while she ropes and rides. She's 5'1" of fun. Two-gun Andy from Diablo sure can twirl a gun and shoot it too with an aim that's true. Better than anyone. Now if you find yourself in danger, wondering what to do, I'll bet that two-gun Andy from Diablo will save the day for you. Hey. Oh yeah. Find yourself in danger, wondering what to do. I bet that two-gun Andy from Diablo will save the day for you. I said that two-gun Andy from Diablo, she will save the day for you.
Will Ryan and the Cactus County Cowboys are with us. Why don't you introduce the guys?
Well, sure thing, Davey. We've got John Reynolds on guitar.
Howdy.
Howdy, John.
Hey.
We sometimes call him Presto. For reasons that may become conspicuous.
And
we've got on fiddle, Buckaroo Benny Bridern.
Yeah, howdy, too.
You guys ready?
Woo!
Woo!
That means yes.
Please welcome Will Ryan and the Cactus County Cowboys.
There's a song out west that everybody knows, and this is how it goes. When the cats away, the mice will play. Joy will be a-jumping every night and day. And they'll wave away what the neighbors say. When the cat's away, when the kitten's gone out on the lawn, the mice will be a-hopping till the break of dawn. In the kitchen too, they'll be pitching wood. When the cat's away, hide, hide, holdy ho, higgery, diggery, dock. Grab a mouse and do-si-do, rocking round the clock. When the feline's out, there'll be no doubt. Every little mouse is gonna swing and shout. They'll behave that way from June through May, long as the cat is away. Hey, when the cat's away, okay. Rocking round the clock. When the feline's out, there'll be no doubt. Every mouse gonna swing and shout. They'll behave that way from June through May, as long as the cat is away. Hey, when the cat's away. Hey, they'll behave that way from June through May, as long as the cat is away.
That was great.
That's our show. Thanks for listening. Special thanks to Matt Perez, Ali Lexa, Jimmy Dore, and of course, Alan Minsky. For additional material and podcasts, or to join our mailing list, please go to davidfeldmancomedy.com. I invite you to friend me on Facebook and follow me on Twitter. From the KPFK studios in Southern California, I'm David Feldman. Thank you for joining us.